Well, it's a brand new breakout show right here on 10 where everyday Australians try to disappear without a trace. But last night, the Hunters officially caught their first team. Oh. The Swifty Fifties, best name ever, were unsuccessful in their mission to avoid being captured. Have a look.
Oh, what was that?
Hunters.
Oh, no!
That's her.
That's her.
Go, go.
Michelle, oh, another hunt is over. Oh, my God! Yes!
Your time on the run is definitely over.
Wipe that smile off your face.
Come on.
I don't know who you are.
I think you do. I think you do, and I think you know who we're after, OK? You know who's in there, OK? There's nowhere she can go. We've got the place surrounded. Just get it over and done with. You've been hunted down. Your time on the run is over.
Angie and Michelle join us now from Burley Waters on the Gold Coast. Oh, you got caught. You were the first ones caught. How did it feel?
Not happy Jan. Not happy Jan is how I felt.
Were you surprised how quickly?
I tell you, that intro was giving me goosebumps all over again.
Oh. Yes and no, because my gut feeling, I should have gone with the gut feeling, and knowing now you have to be 10 steps in front of the hunters, and we were 10 steps behind. So it just wasn't our day. But
no, well, it wasn't our 48-hour day. Yeah. I mean, I think from the time we jumped out of that, well, I jumped out of the truck, that's when I hurt my knee. So I knew as soon as I hit that concrete, I was in my head, I was like, okay, change plans, because everything that we actually had lined up
went
to
out
do,
the window.
Went out the window. So you just had to evolve with it and go with the flow. Mm-hmm. And I was just kind of hoping against hope, saying, you know, I just want to sit down, I want to ice it, take a cup of Panadol, I'll be right as rain. But you don't get that option when you're on the run. That's the tricky part. You know, the whole idea is they just want to keep the pressure on, and they did that. And
we had a Barry Crocker, basically. That's all you can put it down to.
A couple of fabulous birds like yourselves.
They went with the weakest.
No, well, I thought you girls were in with a shot. A couple of fab girls from the, you know, from the Gold Coast. Ready to run.
We did too. Honestly, we wouldn't have applied if we didn't think we got a shot. But
what was your strategy?
It was just bad luck.
What was your strategy going in? Fun.
Run a night.
To play with our heads. For me, to use the three C's, cool, calm and collected.
Okay, I thought she was going to say something
which
else.
Which is something that I can't do on a normal situation. So I was going to try really hard to be cool, calm and collected. But you've got no idea your stress levels, your anxiety levels, your paranoia. Every car going past, I'm like, oh, my God.
So the good thing is we thought we'd be a brilliant team because we're opposites. Like where she gets anxious and stresses, I'm very cool, calm and collective, and I can't just think outside. But
you were a brilliant team.
Apple cart on the word go.
You both knew what was going on in your minds while you were in all of these very highly stressed, highly dramatic moments. But watching it back for the first time, you would have been seeing what the hunters were doing. How did you feel about how they were talking about you?
Oh, wait, I'm going to meet them one day. Don't you worry about that. I'll be seeing them on a street. I'll get my own back.
We've got a scorecard to settle here, Team Swifty 50.
Oh, I might just join the police force just to... who wouldn't do what that was their job. They had to do what they did, and we did what we did, and that's what makes the game, unfortunately.
Them high-fiving, all of them getting together.
Yeah.
I mean, we made it easy for them, seriously. They're having a celebration like it's New Year's Eve.
I'm dying to ask you, Angie, because you have a bit of a connection to fugitives, right? Your dad was actually on the run for most of his life. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
True. I mean, Foxy also knows the story because she's married to my brother. And that's one of the reasons as well we thought it'd be a great idea. I mean, you know, this is going to answer so many questions that I always wanted to know anyway. And that's why I thought we'd make a great team, because I've got that experience, and it was... strange for me growing up, you know. Well, it wasn't strange for me, this was the norm, you know, like living every day, one day at a time, you know, never knowing what school you go to or even not even going to school half the time. So,
wow.
And then when I see families living this normal life, I'd be like, you're weird. How can you stay in one place for so long? And, you know, so I guess, you know, you don't think about it when you're in that situation, and then you get older and you realise that, you know, something's not sitting right. So then that's when I went off on my own and I realised that was a lifestyle I was living. That is not the norm. But it's just, you know, I think it's been great for me to get out there and kind of relive it, because where it was, you know, I'm finding so much, you know, relief. Like someone said the other day, maybe she should go and see a shrink and not go on a show. But I actually found this amazing, like, life experience. That, yeah. I mean, where else am I going to get this kind of answers? I could be sitting in a couch, like, for hours on end and not still get that.
Yeah.
Those answers that I've been, you know, asking myself for years and years, and
what a journey
just
that
the experience was to do this. Yeah,
incredible.
To do this legally was great.
The amount of energy that it would have taken for your dad to constantly stay one step ahead, as you found out in the few hours that you spent in this show. I mean, that's an incredible insight.
It is, and where else are you going to learn that? You know, quite honestly, unless you have to go through it. And I didn't really want to turn to that life of crime that he led, because I know it gets you. So kids today, don't do the time, don't do the crime. So
don't come to us for any lessons on how to get away from the police.
Just keep your fingers crossed for season two of The Hunted. The hunt continues tonight, I think, as it does. Yeah. A brand new episode of The Hunted tonight at 7:30 on 10 and 10 Play on Demand. Angie Michelle, thank you so much for joining us. And wow,
you
were great to watch.
Thank you. Thanks for having us.
So sorry you got caught.
No, thank you.
Thank you for joining us.
Swifty Fifties.
Oh, they were fantastic. Great girls. Angie and Michelle.